Hello, Cancers. How are you? I hope this finds you well. So we are going to be doing your person on your mind reading, whoever you're thinking about. That is who this reading is intended for. And everything that you'll need to know, whether it's about this reading or scheduling your personal readings, all of that is in the description box below for you. Now, today is the last day to get your orders in for this person on your mind special. Everything that you guys will need to know about that is posted on the community page for you. It is a recorded video reading for 2222. And like I said, everything's on the community page if you're interested. All right, my loves, let's take a look and see what we have going on for you guys. Cancer, we're looking at the person on your mind, Cancer. We have the King of Pentacles. We have the Nine of Cups. We have the Star. We have the Ace of Pentacles. We have the Fool. We have the Wheel of Fortune. And at the bottom of the deck for the general overall energy, we have the Knight of Pentacles. It is being influenced by the Moon card. And I guess this one really wants to come too. We have the Strength, the Moon, and the Ten of Swords influencing this Knight of Pentacles. Kind of feels like somebody has been dragging their feet here after an ending. Got this moon energy here. Some of you guys, it's like either that somebody has been, you guys have separated and somebody's kind of dragging their feet and moving back towards you here. Or dragging their feet and ending something else to be able to move back towards you here. This kind of feels a little messy, Cancer. I'm going to be honest with you. It's feeling a little bit messy. So this may not resonate for most of my Cancers, okay? So if it doesn't, that's okay. Just check out some of your other placements, my love. I definitely feel like this is somebody here that you guys have been... you have been in their life for a long time, or they've known you for a very long time, because they're viewing you as the King of Pentacles, right? They could also be viewing you as somebody who is wanting something solid, stable, committed, serious, somebody who's been serious about them. The Nine of Cups for their feelings. I'm going to be honest, I don't typically always get this from the Nine of Cups, but it feels a little bit to me like somebody is kind of good where they are. The Nine of Cups can be a card of feeling happy, content, and satisfied. And that's showing up as their feelings. The way that this is kind of feeling to me is, Cancer, I feel like this is somebody that you guys could have been with for quite some time. And then if separated, and maybe they have gotten into some other kind of connection here. But I feel like they could have recently started to either reach out to you, communicate with you, or they will be doing that here with this Wheel of Fortune energy and this Fool energy here. So it's kind of like they're trying to like have a foot in both worlds. That's what this is feeling like, okay? So I know it's very specific, so that may not be most of your stories, and that's perfectly fine. Just check out some of your other placements, but that's what this is feeling like. So either somebody's getting ready to come back and interact with you while still being with this other person, or they already are, okay? And the thing is why I feel like it's showing up that like they're really dragging their feet here, because they could be telling you that they are going to end things, and you could just be lacking clarity. Like, when are they going to do this? Are they really going to do that? Is that really going to happen? And I feel like you're trying to be very hopeful that will happen. And I feel like they're telling you that it will happen. And I feel like you are almost like a comfort to them here, especially with this King of Pentacles energy showing up. Like there is something, because you guys have been in, like maybe you guys were together for a very long time, or you've been in their life for a very long time, or you're very solid and stable. Like there's something about either, you know, your history or your energy that is like a comfort to this person, and they're not quite ready to let it go, you know? And I feel like at the same time, though, they're hesitating to release whatever this is, this other connection. They are telling you that they're going to, and I have not done that yet. Now their intention could be to do so here. They have the Star card. So they're trying to remain hopeful. They could have a specific outcome that they are trying to see take place here with that star energy. They could also just be recognizing that there's probably going to be a lot of healing that's going to need to take place in this situation here between the two of you. With this Ace of Pentacles here as a challenge, one, I kind of feel like this is a couple things. One, this could just be in the past, they could have really messed things up here, and they could feel like they kind of have blown things here, and there's just a lot that's going to need to take place in order to heal things between the two of you. So it just kind of feels like a lot of work, you know? But I also feel like this is just also this other new energy that is in their life kind of being the challenge here, this other person. Now, their next action towards you is the Fool card. Now, and it's with this Wheel of Fortune. So I definitely feel like if somebody has not already, you know, re-entered your life, I feel like they will be with this energy. It's like somebody's taking that chance. And it does feel like taking a chance because, like I said, I feel like it feels so, it's coming through as so risky because it feels like they're still dealing with this other situation here. So let's take a look at this. Tell me about this Fool energy. We have the Tower. Yeah, and they kind of know that you could kind of bring things crashing down. You could expose them here. The Sun card shines its light on things. It's like everything is out in the open. So I feel like this person knows that by like coming back towards you or reaching out to you, that you could expose them to this other person that they're still involved with here. Especially if you were not interested in reconnecting. The thing that is worrisome to me here, and we're going to have to look at it a little further, is it does kind of look like they're trying to just maintain both, because I do feel like they're on some level here with this Nine of Cups. I feel like they are content where they are. So I feel like they are content with this other person. But they also, like, you are that comfort. Like, they also want to reconnect with you too. And it, to me, it looks like it could get very messy. Okay. Tell me a little bit more about this Moon energy. I feel like they do have hidden intentions. So they may be telling you that they're ready to leave, but I don't feel like that's quite the truth, because I feel like that's why they're dragging their feet here. Yeah, they're still indecisive, and they're not being upfront with you about that, because they're making it seem like they've already made their mind up. They just have things to handle, but that's not the case, okay? They have not made up their mind. We have the Eight of Pentacles, the Six of Swords, and the World. Yeah, so I feel like they are trying to focus on figuring this out with this Eight of Pentacles. Like, I feel like they're focused on it. The Six of Swords and the World card, you know, could end up being a move or having to close something out. So I don't know if this person is, like, would have to, like, move locations or move homes or something of that nature, too, for some of you guys. But there's definitely, they know that in order to be able to come and work on things with you, that they have to fully close this other thing out. That's what this is feeling like to me. I'm going to be honest here. I don't see that yet. I see this person coming back towards you. And I feel like they're not being 100% upfront with you. I feel like that's what Spirit wants you to know right now, is that this person is making it seem like they've made up their mind 100%. But that's not the case. And that's why they're dragging their feet. That's why it already hasn't happened yet. Because they have not made up their mind yet. What is the advice here? Yeah, we got that Two of Swords, kind of more confirmation. And I feel like Spirit, with this set energy too, I feel like, one, this is just more confirmation that they haven't, okay, and they're not being honest with you. But also, Cancer, I feel like this is Spirit. In the Two of Swords, she's blindfolded. So she's like, I can't see clearly. I don't know what to do, right? But her hands are not bound. She could just set the swords down and take the damn blindfold off, and then she could see just fine. But sometimes we don't want to see something. We don't want to look at something. And the Two of Swords also does ask us to look within for the answer. It says that you already know, okay? You don't even have to look without because you already know. So I feel like deep down there's a part of you that knows that this person isn't being upfront with you. You know that they're not being 100% honest. You know that they really haven't made up their mind. Sometimes we just want to believe something, you know? But I feel like Spirit's wanting you to really be honest with yourself, okay? But I feel like that's the advice here. You have the Nine of Wands here as well. So the Nine of Wands is like, I'm not ready to give up on this. I'm not ready to let it go. The thing with the Nine of Wands is sometimes that's a really positive energy. It is, you know, when it comes to like completing our goals, you know, running our business, you know, the Nine of Wands, like getting back down and getting back up again can be really positive. But the other thing to remember is, you know, he's wounded because he won't stop fighting the war. And we have to ask ourselves, is the war worth fighting? Or have we already lost it? You know, are we still fighting something that's already over? So I feel like Spirit's just wanting you to take a really honest look and be honest with yourself, Cancer, whatever that looks like for you. Okay. I'm going to be sending you guys extra love and light and prayers. But that is what I have for you. I do hope that this helps. If it resonates, let me know. If it doesn't, that's okay. Just check out your other placements and everything that you need to know, whether it's about this reading or scheduling your personal readings, all of that is in the description box below for you. And if you want personal prayers for any reason, just put the little prayer emoji in the comments down below and I will go through and pray for you. But if this is where we part, thank you guys so much for being here and I will see you next time.